A happy pup is a happy driver. A tired pup is a happy driver. God. I already fucked up. A tired pup is a happy driver, so let's go. I have 3 hours and 37 minutes. I should be there by 3:30. It is 12 o'clock. Almost there. All right. Ready to go, babe? Almost there. This is Stormy's first camping trip. She's been camping before, but not like this. Like, it's just gonna be us two. I think the farthest she's gone, probably a 2 hour car ride, 3 hours. This is about a 6 hour car ride. We're about 3 hours in. This is also my first solo camping trip. I've been waiting to do this for fucking years, honestly, if I'm being real. Almost there. We're pretty much here, actually. I'm trying to read the map to know where to go, you know? I'm just gonna follow. I suck at maps. I suck at them. So I'm just gonna follow the road and hope for the best. I mean, what could go wrong, you know? Get a little lost. Everyone's been lost at some point in their life. I mean, I'm mentally lost. I might as well be physically lost as well. Comfy as hell. Ta-da! What I have been planning to do for the past like 3-4 years. I know it's not that big of a deal, like I'm just camping, but it's fucking exciting. Like, good morning. I slept so fucking good. Oh my god, you guys, I was so comfortable last night. Took me a while to go to sleep because it was raining and Stormy kept growling at something outside of the car. So there was quite a bit of noise going on. I ended up taking an Ativan, which is an anxiety pill, and it helped me sleep. Because I was also experiencing a bit of anxiety. I think just because it was my first night. It was about nothing in particular. Like, I wasn't scared of anyone or anything, really, that was outside of my tent, because I knew there was nothing. I was just more scared of, like, Stormy bolting, so I had to tie her up, and then I immediately felt better after that. I feel like I would have woken up without her in the car with me if I didn't, so. Because that tent, it's not good quality. This bed is so fucking comfy. I mean, I'm kind of on a slant, so I could only sleep on the one side, and then if I turned to the other side, I would be sliding a little bit, and it was a little uncomfortable, but the one side I was sleeping on, very comfy. All I've wanted for so long is to just be able to... Not only was the car ride up here Stormy's longest car ride, is also her longest hike that we're ever doing together. Yeah, she's doing good so far. She swam a little bit, brought her to a few beaches. We've been taking breaks. She's doing good for a 9-year-old. Bye, Silent Lake. I'll miss you. This morning I walked to like the service center to go, and there was a girl there with her card. She looked like she was like packing up and stuff. She complimented Stormy. As I was walking away, I had said, "Safe travels. It looks like you're going solo, eh?" And she was like real nervous, like immediately, like a flip switch. She was like, "Yeah." And I was like, "Oh fuck." And I didn't say I'm solo too. Because I didn't, that was like a really creepy interaction, and I'm thinking about it now, and I can't stop thinking about it because I really feel bad. I feel like I like really creeped her out. Woman solo travelers are like a different breed. We need to be very careful. I wish I had said to her, "Oh, I'm solo too. Gang gang," but I didn't because I'm fucking stupid. And now I just feel creepy. So, hey girl, if you're watching this, I'm very sorry that I creeped you out, but I want to let you know that I'm solo too. I'm on the highway and I'm making a complete stop. This is what I get for being in Toronto, I guess. Like, mama needs a meal. Mama's hungry. Tomogamy near North Bay in Ontario right now, and I'm staying at an off-grid cottage with my friend. My best friend, her dad owns this, so we're staying up here for a few days. It's our last full day though. I've already been here for like 2 days. Trip on Thursday to Sunday. We're going up to Sault Ste. Marie, going just in the middle of the bush. I'm excited. There's no toilet, no water, nothing. Like, it's a spot with a private beach, and we took it for $35 a night. So we're just gonna set up a tent and hope for the best. Thank you for tuning into my first YouTube video. Okay, this is awkward. Should I not even do outros? I feel like I shouldn't do outros. I'll just stop the video whenever my trip ends, I guess. That's gonna be the way we're doing it. So this is the first and only outro that I will be doing. Thank you for joining me. I will see you guys when I see you guys. Should I do that? Like, should I do that? Do you think that would be good? I'm gonna do it, okay.